grandma and grandpa painted a picture of 65 years in one little house. More than a memory, more than saying I do. Kiss you good nights and I love yous. Me and you, baby, we'll walk in the footsteps, build our own family, one day at a time. 10 little toes, a painted pink room. Our beautiful baby looks just like you. And we'll build this love from the ground up. Now till forever, it's all of me, all of you. Just take my hand and I'll be the man your dad hoped that I'd be. And we'll build this love from the ground up, for worse or for better. And I will be all you need. Beside you I'll stand, through the good and the bad. We'll give all that we have. And we'll build this love from the ground up. This life will go by in the blink of an eye, but I wouldn't wanna spend it without you by my side. The clouds are gonna roll, the earth's gonna shake, but I'll be a shelter through the wind and the rain. And we'll build this love till forever, it's all of me, all of you. Just take my hand and I'll be the man your dad hoped that I'd be. And we'll build this love from the ground up, for worse or for better. And I will be all you need. Beside you I'll stand, through the good and the bad. We'll give all that we have. And this love from the ground up. Someday we'll wake up with thousands of pictures of 65 years in this little house. I won't trade for nothing the life that we built. I'll kiss you goodnight and say I love you still. And we'll build this love from the ground up, for worse or for better.
That I'm still breathing. was my head shaking, and you were the reason. My heart keeps bleeding. I need you now.
If I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure the light defeated the dark.
Today, we've come together to witness the joining of these two lives. For them, out of the routine of ordinary life, the extraordinary has happened. From meeting in math class to making moves through AIM chat room, these high school sweethearts are now finalizing it with their wedding. Cynthia and Kao, God knew your needs when he brought you together. He knew exactly what you needed to make you complete. And now, he wants you to commit yourselves to each other as the one he has chosen to complete you. Let's all bow our heads in prayer. Lord, we thank you for gathering everyone here today. We ask that you help Cynthia and Kao to remember the strong love that they share, to work that love into practical things so that nothing can divide them. May their love always inspire them to be kind in their words, considerate of the other's feelings, and concerned for the other's needs and wishes. Increase their faith and trust in you. Bless their marriage with peace and happiness, and make their love fruitful for your glory, and make their joy complete, both here and in eternity. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
1 John chapter 4, verse 12 says, "No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is made complete in us." While the commitment begins with the two of you, its effect radiates outward. It touches your family and friends and ultimately all of society. Your marriage will be a platform to which the world could get a glimpse of God by the way you love each other as husband and wife, respecting, honoring, and serving one another. When this commitment is seriously made and continuously fulfilled, it leads to the richest and most rewarding of all human relationships. And your relationship will take more than just love. It will take trust to know in your hearts that you want only the best for each other. Dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and grow, even when it is difficult to do so. And faith to go forward together without knowing what the future holds for you both. While love is our natural state of being, these other qualities are not as easy to come by. I've gotten the privilege to know the both of you personally, and I can see in you the trust, dedication, and faith it would take to have a thriving marriage. Kao, ever since you were little, you were always a man of few words, but when you do speak up, the whole room goes silent and ears are attentive. Proverbs chapter 17, verse 28 says, "A truly wise person uses few words. A person with understanding is even tempered." I think many people, such as myself, believe it to be true of you. You also like to keep a small circle. Right? Anyone lucky enough to find themselves in that circle will find that you are a loyal, trustworthy, honest, and respectful person. Then one day, you brought Cynthia into your circle, and since then, I've never seen you so passionate, devoted, and sure of yourself. I knew she was the one for you. I saw the way she would light up your world, the smile on that face that you can't even wipe off, the way she inspires you, challenges you, and brings out the best in you. I mean, look at how many fish you can catch now, right? And guess what? You'll never have to fall in line at the food bank again. I can't imagine anyone more perfect for you than Cynthia. Speaking of Cynthia, you are always so sweet and a joy to have around. I still remember when you first joined us for youth camp way back when. Being new to the idea of church was one thing, but you got more than you bargained for, because this church is actually his family. Your dedication to your loved one is admirable. I have no doubt that you will take good care of Kao, because you've already demonstrated that when he had his episode and was bedridden at the hospital. You stay strong for him, mentally and emotionally. And physically, on the other hand, I know he's ready to protect you. And you have nothing to worry about. I taught him the infamous rock bottom and stone cold stutter, all right? And no one wants to mess with the tornado DDT, right? You still remember those moves, right? If not, that's what little brothers are for. Right? As two halves which love has brought together to share this journey of life, I invite you now to reach out to one another to take hand in marriage. Feeling these hands, I want you to know that these are the hands of your best friend, young, strong, and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as you build a future together. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will be folded in prayer to praise God for the blessings in your life and to seek his strength and guidance to overcome trials in your life. These are the hands that will one day tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you hold your family together as one. Lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled in age, will still be reaching out for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness of love with just one touch. Cynthia and Kao, marriage is a gift from God, given to us so that we might experience the joys of unconditional love with a lifelong partner. God designed marriage to be an intimate relationship between a man and woman. And Cynthia and Kao, because your deep love for each other comes from God above, this is a sacred moment and a powerful step, one that is not entered into lightly. It is with great reverence that I now ask you, here in the witness of your loved ones, do you come here today freely with conviction in your whole heart, mind, body, and spirit to enter into marriage? If so, please say, we do.
We do.
Kao, do you take Cynthia to be your lawful wedded wife? If so, please say, I do.
I do.
Do you promise before God and these witnesses that you will be to her a true and devoted husband, true to her in sickness and in health, in joy and in sorrow, in prosperity and adversity, and forsaking all others, you will keep yourself to her and to her only? If so, please say, I do.
I do.
And Kao, you may offer your personal vows.
Okay.
We have been waiting for this day for what felt like forever, but today is the day we get to live out our dreams. Today, we get to start a new journey in our relationship. You have always been there to support everything I do. Having you in my life has forever changed me for the better. I promise to grow with you and build with you a better life each day as we learn from each other. To be patient, kind, giving, and always to cherish every day together. I promise to support you with everything you do, and I promise to encourage you to continue to live out your dreams. I promise to always treat you with the utmost respect. I promise to give you everything that you've ever wanted and to be the man that you've dreamt of. I promise to live and care for you like you have cared for me in my time of need. I promise to be by your side always and forever.
Cynthia, do you take Cal to be your lawful wedded husband? If so, please say I do.
I do.
Do you promise before God and these witnesses that you will be to him a true and devoted wife, true to him in sickness and in health, in joy and in sorrow, in prosperity and adversity, and forsaking all others, you will keep yourself to him and to him only? If so, please say I do.
I do.
And Cynthia, you may also offer your personal vows.
Seven years ago, it all began with your yearbook. By the time I knew it, we had our first date to sing I Do. I remember those endless nights of webcamming and late night phone calls like they were yesterday. I'll never forget that moment you asked me to sign your yearbook. That was the beginning of you and I. After all these years, the way I felt about you is still there. And when I'm with you, I feel safe. Today, I promise to always appreciate you, challenge you, respect you, and support you. I promise to kiss you in the mornings before I leave to work. I promise to always make you laugh, as making you happy is the most important thing to me in the world. I promise to go fishing as long as you take care of anything slimy, scaly, and pokey. I promise to let you have soda on the weekends. I promise to have your back no matter what. I promise to let you fight your own battles, but we'll tap in when you need help. I promise to love you and own you. And today, I give you my hand, my heart, and my love, always and forever.
May I please have the rings?
The wedding ring
serves as a symbol of the promises you have just spoken. It is the outward and visible sign of an inward and invisible love that binds your hearts together. The wedding ring also is a symbol of what God is. He is without beginning and without end. He is eternal. As you can see, the ring is without beginning and without end. So I believe this exchange of rings not only reminds us of the unending love you have for each other, but also reflects the eternal love God has for each of you. And may it remind you that you are now a part of a love that has always been and always will be. Cal, please take this ring, place it on Cynthia's finger, and repeat after me.
Okay.
I, Cal.
I, Cal.
Take you, Cynthia.
Take you, Cynthia.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
To death do us part.
This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a token of my love and devotion.
As a token of my love and devotion.
Cynthia, please take this ring, place it on Kyle's finger, and repeat after me. Okay. I, Cynthia.
Take you, Kyle.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer or poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part. This ring I give you. As a token of my love and devotion. By virtue of the authority vested in me as Deputy Commissioner of Civil Marriage, I now pronounce you husband and wife. And Cal, probably waiting for this, you may kiss your bride. As it says in Mark chapter 10, verses 7 through 9, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we ask your blessing upon these two lives and the home they are establishing today. May the love they have for each other grow deeper and stronger because of their love for you, Lord. Guide them to each other as you've guided them in this new journey. Guide them in this new journey as husband and wife. And as they walk down this path, light their way so they may keep their eyes focused on your will and their hands holding fast to your truth, and their feet firmly planted in your word, and their hearts bound together by your love. In this we pray in your name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
All right. Family and friends, it is my greatest honor to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Kao and Cynthia Sechow.
And I pinch myself, you're with me, not someone else. And I'm scared, yeah, I'm still scared. That is all a dream. Cause you still look perfect as days go by. Even the worst ones, you make me smile. Stop the world if it gave us time. Cause when you love someone, you open up your heart. When you love someone, you make room. If you love someone and you're not afraid to lose them, you probably never loved someone like I do. Probably never loved someone like I do. When you say you love the way I make you feel, everything becomes so real. Don't be scared, no, don't be scared, 'cause you're all I need. And you still look perfect as days go by. Even the worst ones, you make me smile. I'd stop the world if it gave us time. 'Cause when you never love someone like I do, you probably never love.
just standing there in that dress. What it's doing to me in a secret. everybody. Let's hear it for Kao and Cynthia. First dance.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for coming to join my daughter and my new son-in-law. They're happy today. I want to make a toast for her and for my new son-in-law. This is for you, Kao. Welcome to the family, and thank you so much for making my daughter so happy. I just want to share to everybody that when I first met Kao, I was trying to protect my daughter every morning and think that Kao would not be good enough for my daughter. Oh boy, what happened? Forever. What the best?
I don't know if any of you are lucky as I am, but if you are happy.
A son-in-law, I have a son. And he also my partner, and we work together. So that me is so perfect. And thank you so much for coming and welcome to the family. This is for you, my daughter. I love you so much. I'm so happy that you are happy today. I wish that I can give you everything. But there's one thing that I cannot give you. Your dad standing here today. But I want you to know that the day that I have you, I was all alone bringing you to my into this world. And today, I'm giving you away to your husband, and I was all alone, but important every single minute. And you go ahead and make your life perfect, and be happy, and take care of your husband, and love him as much as you love me. Love you so much. That's my love for you. Thank you, everyone.
Next will be Kao's parents, May and Son.
Hello, and welcome everyone. For those of you that do not know me, I'm Adrian and Kao's younger brother of two, or three. No. The first thing I want to do is thank my mom and dad for an okay brother, and Cynthia's parents for bringing someone into my brother's life who has made him so happy every day of the relationship. Then to y'all, thank you for all making it here today. I know that Kao was very selective, also Cynthia, of who they wanted to invite here. So just being here, I know, has brought them a lot of joy as you all meet someone so important into your lives. And I also want to give a special thanks to those who will be translating my speech, whether it is into Mien or Hmong. Thank you so they can also listen as well. One recurring conversations that my brother and I would have with our cousins when we were younger was about who would get married first between all of us. And I have to tell you, Kao was not on the top of the list. Well, when I first heard that Kao got a girlfriend, we were all shook. And fast forward today, we're at Kao's and Cynthia's wedding. Can you believe that? Kao's wedding. If I was given one word to describe my brother as a person, I would use the word rock. I say rock because he's so hard-headed. Nah, I'm kidding. He's not so hard-headed. It's just how solid and reliable he is as a person. A brother that Ken and I didn't even have to worry about when he was bedridden for months. We knew that it was nothing that he couldn't get over. And I'm glad that he has found someone just as strong as he to compliment him, his soulmate, Cynthia. It's hard for me to recall a moment that I knew Cynthia was meant for Kao. It always seemed that there were two peas in the pod, two individuals so perfect for each other. While everyone is trying to find someone they can live the rest of their lives with, these two found someone they can live the rest of their lives without. I am so grateful to call Cynthia my sister, and I know my mom is sure finally happy to call someone her daughter, and maybe even eventually a granddaughter. So please join me in raising a glass to these two happy peas in the pod. Ren?
Do these.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, that's enough, that's enough.
So if you will, please raise your glass. And to Kao and Cynthia, we wish you the best.
All right, and next up will be Cynthia's maids of honor and sisters, Selena and Lena.
Selena, Cynthia's younger sister. So, to my dearest sister, it's hard to think of something to say, but I realized that the best thing to say are the words that come from my heart. Seeing you happy makes me happy. You're starting a new chapter in your life, and I'm honored to see you on this day and share this moment with you. And my new brother-in-law, we've gone through so much together as sisters, and I've seen you become the woman you are. Though you're older than me, because I've always looked up to you when we were younger, even till this day. I've been blessed to call you my sister. Enjoy your wedding day, sister, because you've been waiting for this day to come, and here we are, all here to celebrate with you and my new brother, Cal. Not only that, I don't have six brothers anymore, but seven. Enjoy this night and your future together. Congratulations, sister, I love you.
Okay, so hi, I'm Melina, Cynthia's youngest sister, and Cynthia's tallest sister. yeah, so I didn't write my speech down because I wanted to say it from my heart, because I'm just really happy to be here with you. Sorry, I thought it was stronger than this. But yeah, I'm so happy to be here with you today. We've grown up together and done so much stuff together. Yeah. And I'm happy that you found someone like Cal, because this is the happiest that you've been since forever. And yeah. I won't embarrass you this time, so I'm not gonna spill her whole life story and her embarrassing moments with her and Cal, but yeah, I'm just really happy to be here with you today and celebrate my new brother.
By, and I've been holding everything inside, but now I've got nothing left to hide. Well, I'm with you, oh you, but I can see how strong a man I'm gonna have to be to do for you. It comes so naturally, some way you move. All I want is a chance to prove, show all I can do. I believe in starting over, I can see that your heart is true. I believe in good things coming back to you. You're the light that lifts me higher, so bright to guide me through. I believe in you. If you want to hold on to me tight, you don't have
kiss? Can you guys do a kiss?
You say you'll be down in 5. The smell of your perfume is floating down the stairs. You're fixing up your hair like you do. I know that I'll be a mess the second that I see you. You won't be surprised. It happens every time. It's nothing new. It's always on a night like tonight. I thank God you.
I said my money is great, and my thumb does good, and if I pop that thing, everybody here, help me count down for Cynthia. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold it up. Hold it up. She got it. I was here for her.
Big hug. Big hug.
Normally the single guys don't give themselves up so fast. They must see something.
Good potential.
They must see how happy Kao is. Right.
One more.
So, Kao, do we have all your unmarried guys, or do you look around the room and see some names? And by the way, just for everyone out there, if you see a guy and he's hiding his left hand like in his pocket like this, it probably means they're guilty of not being out here when they should be. So, pinch him a little bit and send him on their way out here. And Cal, how do you feel now? You got them all? Oh, he's throwing a football. Now you guys have no excuse. Wait, none of you guys brought tacky gloves, nothing? Oh, man. No wide receivers in the bunch. All right, Cal, you ready?
Yeah.
Do you want to count down? All right, everybody, let's count down from 5, 4, 3. Thank you, everybody. The mic to the happy couple themselves, Kao and Cynthia. So if everybody could please rise up for just a moment and give your attention to the head table, and I will pass the mic to them right now.
Of you who have been married for many years will be willing to offer advice when needed. We are committed to staying married for the long haul, and we know it will be so much easier with all your help by our sides. Enjoy the rest of the party, and again, thank you all so much for being here today. It means more to the both of us than it ever could express. So don't forget to come back on the dance floor and dance with us, okay? Don't forget to hit it.
All right, that's the prize orders, everybody. Come on out to the dance floor. We don't have that much time left, so let's celebrate their wedding while we can. Come on, everybody, let's go.
Thank you.
Kiss again, kiss.